Hello everyone, this is Bob and Threadbare, and welcome back to Brutal Legend. And this time I'm going to try and show you guys what to do with all of those giant stone heads, but... Well, just a second, I need to raise this relic first.
Who would ever bury something that awesome?
Alright, now with that done, we can just go right... Oh, damn it.
Nice Thunderhawk, man. You make that badass heel mobile yourself?
Hey, you about done?
Let me check that out.
So, when are you gonna tell us how you got hurt?
I'm not.
Why?
Because then you wouldn't let me go back and finish the job.
No, that's Lars. I like watching you fight.
All right. Meet me at the Razor Fields if you want to see some more. But please, don't tell Lars, okay?
All right, but before we do any of that, looks like we can talk to the Killmaster.
You're a natural on that thing, man.
We were made for each other.
I got a hangnail. Think you can heal that?
I don't have strings that small.
Ophelia looks good as new.
Yeah, like keep it that way.
You're a natural on that thing, man.
We were made for each other.
Thanks.
How long do you think I should let my hair grow?
You guys talk now? Or still aloof?
Yeah, we were just fucking with you.
So you guys are like medics or something, huh?
I just play music, man. If that makes people feel good, so be it.
You guys should build some more bikes.
Yeah, they don't look too hard to make.
Great addition to the team, huh?
I've been trying to get the Killmaster to join us for years. How did you do it?
I just told him what a great leader you are, man.
Really? Huh.
So what do you say we go bust those ladies out of the Pleasure Tower now?
Soon. I'm trying to come up with a plan that's safe for Ophelia.
This place is kind of a pickle jar, man.
I know. I'm formulating a plan to recruit more women. Do you think it's the bathrooms? We need nicer bathrooms.
Great addition to the team, huh?
I've been trying to get the Killmaster to join us for years.
Yeah, you can talk to pretty much everybody between missions, and for the most part, they have different things to say each time. Now this song always gets me thinking about trends in music. Like how disco seems to be back, essentially. I mean, punk didn't really kill the metal, but they did manage to kill the disco. And for that, we thank them. But now it seems like disco is back. It's just morphed into this house hip-hop crap that's popular on the charts these days. Punk really ought to come back and kill it again. Or something even better, like if jazz just showed up out the hell out of nowhere and killed house music dead. That would be awesome. Case. Looks like we've reached a rather interesting location here, down by the pit full of the, what do you call them, it's the razor fire boars. And, yeah, actually it's got this thing here, let's have a look. would appear that this is a shrine to women of metal. You know something else I like about this game? Is that by and large, and when you take the tainted coil just within its own context, the women of this game, by and large, wear more clothing than the men do.
Ladies?
I'd like you to meet my Razor Girls. All of these women have escaped from General Lionwhite's pleasure tower.
With your help, I suppose?
I've kept them a secret for their own protection, but now they want to fight, and I'm here to arm them.
With pigs?
The carcass of the Razor Fire Boar, when properly dissected, can be turned into a powerful long-range weapon.
This is what almost killed you, isn't it? Well, if you're gonna try it again, I'm gonna help.
What are we waiting for? Let's go!
This time, though, let's keep the doctor nearby just in case.
I'm gonna drive a couple of them over this way. You stay put until it's time to attack, okay?
When do I get a car?
You have to play, Eddie. I took them as much to help you.
Now, you might be thinking that this is a Motorhead song. Well, you'd be half right. It's a cover of a Motorhead song.
That did it.
Okay, get them while they're hot! What's it do?
Not much, until we rip out the gizzards, flush the chamber, and ream the barrel. Hey, get busy. We need a lot more.
Right.
Hell of a bird you got there, Eddie.
That's right, it's a all-female band cover of a Motorhead song. Also, we do have to wait until the speakers stop sparking until we can do the stun thing again.
Almost there, just a couple more.
Alright, just as soon as they stopped sparking, aw, damn, I got away. God damn, there's some slowdown, but that's a lot of boars out there, that's why. Look at all these things. This is why you can't just go and kill them straight off. Way too many. And they're way too aggressive. They'll kill you instantly if you go out there unprotected.
All right, I think we got it. Let's clean these up. We got bigger pigs to slaughter.
I gotta clean up a little. Meet us back in Bladehenge for a weapons demo?
So that's our new, new unit.
Rocket South! Time to raise hell!
Oh, sweet. Let's get on this big. But yeah, so that's the basic ranged unit right there, is the Razor Girls. And you can see that you can use these guys as well. In fact, most of the critters that you summon with the Call of Nature, you'll end up riding. Now that we've gotten this pig out of that area, it's nice and isolated. Of course, that takes way too long just to grab one, bring it out of the Razor Fire Boar pit, and kill them one by one.
Through it loud.
meantime, I've...
We're just marching around kicking ass.
Well, it's said that there's a few more things at the Motor Forge, so let's go see what they are.
You have interrupted the Guardian of Metal's nap. Yes, take care of your car.
Aha, upgrades.
For the warrior in a hurry.
That ought to help you break some speed records.
Keeps the elk out of your grill. You're like a battering ram now.
That's fairly obvious.
Now here's where things get interesting.
Are you sure you can handle that?
Just a little extra something deadly.
That'll help in a pinch. Take it from me.
The Disgorger is a DLC weapon, but since this is PC, I got all the DLC stuff automatically.
Look. Hello, beautiful. Hello, beautiful. Now there's the real deal. About time someone built that guy a statue. I've got a couple of moves I can show you.
This is still some basic stuff here. Kind of situational here.
Yeah, that's a powerful one. Why not make them come to you?
The grabber doesn't work on everything, unfortunately.
Careful what you pull on. Pain comes in many flavors. These strings come with a free paint. Back to basics.
Huh.
The best strings for combat.
These strings actually do stuff.
That'll really get their attention. Just don't use it when I'm napping.
And that's about all I can afford.
We can buff out the scratches while we're at it. The way Armageddon intended.
Okay, see you later, Guardian of Metal.
Knock him dead!
And now, I am armed. No cooldown, no ammunition counter. You just fire until you feel like not firing anymore.
Breathe the fresh breeze under the Killmaster's joint.
Now, the Disgorger really only hits from the side. So that's something to keep in mind. Anyway, don't mind the cut, but since we have a little more time, I figure I'll show off one more side quest. You've already done the sneak attack, and you've seen what that's all about, but now that we have an armed deuce, we can participate in the lift attacks. Or what do they call it? Death racks. And it looks like he's just over here. Is that glow in the distance? You can see.
We're headed back to Bladehead for some grub.
Hey, nice lift. Can I get an oil change and a lube job?
Oh, man. Eddie Riggs! Oh, can I just say what an honor it is to finally meet you, Mr. Riggs? Whoa, okay. I cannot believe you came all this way to test out my hydraulic death rack.
Death rack?
Yeah! That's why you're here, right? So we can hoist you and your world-famous deuce into the sky? Yeah. Then when the attacking hordes show up, you rain down on them with your car-mounted arsenal of death!
Okay, I'll give this thing a shot.
Right on! I cannot wait to find out if this thing is structurally sound.
How long do I have to wait up here?
I chose this location because it gets attacked all the time. Heads up, Mr. Riggs! Here they come!
Come some more.
So, now I'm in a giant turret. And unfortunately, I can't use the secondary weapons while I'm up here. And as you might imagine, the machine gun isn't actually that strong. I mean, it's the first weapon they let you have.
No.
And you might have also noticed by now, but the enemies also have access to the same new units that we do. Like, they've already got their own Razor Girls and their own... What do you call those things?
They're sneaking up behind us!
Uh-oh. And they also have those bouncers, yet.
Destroy!
Gotta get it before it... Aw, oh, damn it. Too late.
All the way... Don't get...
Took out our trike.
Eddie, they're attacking the lift! My lift!
So, fortunately, you don't have, like... You can't point directly beneath you. But you do have all of these other units under your command to do stuff like take out enemies that you can't really hit from where you are, or are attacking the lift and thus cannot be fired at. But yeah, this is all it ever is, so this is the only one of these you'll ever see, at least until I get new weapons that are in any way more interesting than the machine gun.
Wow, they look just like the little dead ants from up here.
I should let you try next time.
Right, well, that was a certain definition of fun.
I think I should get you a new paycheck.
Anyway, I'm not going to show off any more side quests because all that's left are more sneak attacks and more death racks.
Bring some fresh breeze up to the Killmaster.
Just marching around, kicking ass.
But one thing that I will do is show you how I now have the ability to destroy the Razor Fire Boars. See, the thing about them is that they are either extremely aggressive or extremely defensive. There's also a lot fewer of them now that the mission's over, but there's still more than enough to just straight up murder you if you're not careful. So, yeah, so long as you're in a car, they'll run away when you approach. But luckily, the machine gun is a long enough range that you can kill them from while they're running away from you. Unfortunately, the secondary fire is far too short a range to be very useful against the Razor Fire Boars. But, hey, this is an excuse to listen to a song, so let's just keep on going. Oh, quickly here, just show off the difference. As soon as you get out of the car, they're aggressive as hell. And there's way too many of them to handle. Like, suddenly there's four of them. Now if I can find one and shoot it down. Yeah, once you get an arm deuce, taking out the Razor Fire Boars is no problem at all. Where the hell did they all go? Oh, here they are. Oops.
A new record for boar slaughter.
Bet that hunter's gonna be pissed.
All right, let's get back to him and find out.
Who's in there?
Well, for sure I'd get knocked around by that sign. is the giant iron cross, so it looks like we're almost here. Like the song's almost finished too. Oh, that's close enough.
Can't believe something as ugly as you killed something as cool looking as that.
Oh, I've killed way more Tollisks than this one.
How many?
5.
I can beat that easy.
I'd get moving if I were you.
Alright, Tollisks are those really big guys.
Jackass.
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, killing 5 isn't that hard now that, again, we've got the armed deuce. And back, here's one right now. And really, the secondary fire is very useful against these guys because, yeah, the TLC weapon's actually pretty powerful. Kind of surprised they just handed it out straight off. But then again, there's a lot of very powerful weapons that we get access to eventually. And now that I've killed 6 of them, let's go rub it in the... Well, I've killed everything we have access to now, so I guess that means that the hunter's gone and vanished. I guess I'll have to do all these damn side quests then. Well, while I go do that, I won't subject you to it, so until afterwards, let's have another look at bands you probably haven't heard of unless you live in Europe, maybe. You know what metal needs? More women. Whether you consider it a good thing or not, heavy metal has a reputation for hyper-masculinity, and there are a number of bands who revel in that reputation. I'm looking at you, Manowar. Still, even for a genre known for its volume and aggression, there's room for a more feminine touch. For example, our subject for today, Nightwish. Nightwish is known as a symphonic metal band. Now, symphonic metal is actually pretty hard to pin down. Despite what you might imagine, symphonic elements work well in all kinds of metal, thanks to the genre's focus on longer songs, virtuoso instrumentalists, and topics considered over the top in rock and roll, but which fit right in with classical music. As such, symphonic metal is more an adjective than a proper genre. But when people talk about symphonic metal on its own, they usually mean symphonic power metal with a female lead singer. Nightwish is another Finnish band, and it's had a remarkably solid lineup aside from the lead singer, and we'll get to that. But as such, Nightwish has had a pretty consistent sound throughout their timeline. Soaring, theatrical, operatic. The composer, Tuomas Holopainen, has admitted that he's inspired foremost by film soundtracks. Here's a classic from an early album, Sleeping Sun. Of course, Tarja Turunen's soaring vocals really help with that operatic feel. Anyway, while the sound may not have changed much, as Nightwish grew in popularity, they were able to add in a few different things, like working with a real orchestra, as of their 5th album, Once. Here's an excerpt you actually might have heard without realizing what it was. Ghost Love Score. Unfortunately, after the Once World tour, Nightwish fired Tarunin. Apparently, she and her husband thought of the band one way while the rest of the band considered things differently, but they were kind of dickish for how they did it. They made an announcement in an open letter, and that was how Tarja found out she was fired. So after that, there was a lengthy audition to find a new lead vocalist, and after about a year, Annette Olsen was chosen. Olsen is really the biggest single change to Nightwish's style, since she's a much more traditional singer, compared to Tarunin's operatic style. Here's The Poet and the Pendulum, off of Olsen's first Nightwish album, Dark Passion Play. Personally, I like both singers. Olsen isn't Tarunin, and she isn't trying to be. Although most Nightwish fans will fight to the death over which singer's better. Oddly enough, both camps now have something in common, since Olsen was also fired from Nightwish after their seventh album, Imagineerum, which, by the way, is also a movie. The band cited creative differences again, but the fact that Olsen was pregnant with her third kid and the band was on tour at the time may have been a factor. As for right now, Floor Janssen from After Forever and Revamp is subbing in as singer until the tour ends, and after that it seems like the band will go back on hiatus, at least until they find a new lead singer. But regardless of whether they keep going or not, remember, metal will never die.